This video is going to be kind of quick. Just something that I wanted to do in the meantime. It's kind of a slow period while I'm waiting on more parts to come in the mail, but it doesn't mean it has to be a boring one. So, if you've been following the channel, you know that I have a lot of lights that are basically wired into the rolling shell of my S14. These are both show lights for the headlights and engine bay lights. I tested the engine bay lights and the headlights separately when I made them. They worked, but I need to know if they work with the circuit that I made in the car. So that's kind of what these two wires are for. What I'm planning on doing is giving power and ground to the power distribution box and to the common ground that all of these lights share. Theoretically speaking, that'll make it so that they work, and the only thing that'll turn them on and off outside of the Bluetooth controlling apps is the switches that I have installed. So it's basically just testing to see if the whole circuit works. Granted, this video will have it may look like my driver's side halos and strips are not working. It's because I need extension wires to connect them to the rest of the harness. Those are coming in the mail. But everything else should work. My demon eyes should work. The halos and strips on the passenger side should work. The engine bay lights should work. Everything should be fine. So I went ahead and wired up these connections real quick. I'm basically gonna connect it to the power and ground on the battery in my Honda and then run these wires to the appropriate spots. So with that being said, we can go ahead and just mock this up real quick and cut to the chase.
Got it mocked up.
This one going to the common ground for everything. And this one screwed into the common power wire or line for all of them. And then they should be long enough to just go through that door to where I'm gonna pull the Honda up and connect it to the battery. So let's go ahead and do that real quick, and hopefully, well, it shouldn't light up immediately because the switches are off, but hopefully it works. People that want to know why I'm doing this, if these lights and everything work off of this setup, it basically means that all of the circuitry that I've done is complete. There are no opens, there's no power drains or nothing like that. It basically checks everything all at once and assures me that when I actually do have a battery in the car, I won't have problems with this at least. So that's why I'm doing it. Plus, it's fun to see how the lights look, man. One last look at the setup. Power and ground going through. It's connected, but the switches are not on, so nothing should be on, and so far nothing is on. But just like a sketchy ass connection going through. I'm gonna flip the engine bay light switch and pray that nothing catches fire or blows up, because I will be very sad if that happens. But this should work. It's either gonna go really good or really bad. I think it might be going really bad. Hold on. No, no, it's working. It's working. I have lights. I have lights. Okay. Okay. It's a poor connection. That's what I'm guessing. There's a poor connection. Is it on the ground side? It's on the ground side. Okay, so this thing has to be a little bit tighter. Okay, so I do have lights. That means that that whole circuit works. When it, you know, when this is fine. Hold on, I'm gonna adjust this and see what happens now.
Okay, I have a way better connection to ground now. As you can see.
And as far as that, I just put it in there.
So, this works. I forgot where I put the controller on this thing. I think I've left it on the inside. Should be like down there. Yeah.
Okay. So if I wanted to do jump.
Okay. I'm going to have to try this again at night and show you guys how that looks. So these, these work. Turn that off. Or you could leave it on and turn off the switch. Boop. Now for the headlights. Fingers crossed again. Let's see what happens. Nothing. Alright, so something's going on with the headlight wiring. And there's something that I expect to be the cause of down. Wait, make sure that this is good. These are fine. The thing that I'm expecting it to be for the headlights is this common that I have right here. I don't know if that's making a connection. So let's switch that around and try it again. Little bit of an update. It seems like everything is getting power. I don't think that everything is getting ground. So I have fixed the high beam RGBW bulbs, as it was literally just the connectors were twisted in the wrong way. It's four prongs in a circle. And if you have them in any type of orientation, it won't work. So those work now. As far as the halos and LED strips, those are on the same circuit. And I honestly have no idea what's going on with them. Those are these plugs right here. And I can't for the life of me figure out what's going on. So we have 12 volts to the fuse for them, which goes into here. This is like a current limiter type of thing. So it turns the 12 volts into 5 volts, and then it pushes the 5 volts out to the LEDs and strips. There's nothing in between here and here outside that I've done outside of a braided connection, which is this one. And I checked it, I have 5 volts, but I don't think I'm getting ground. However, if I come to the grounding point, I am getting ground. Let's see, let me right now I have the negative lead plugged up to power, so let's just see what happens if I go to that specific one. Now I know the one for the LED halos and strips is the only one that has this like copper line on it. It's like made out of copper instead of the ones that I've done. There it is. So let's see what that says. And it's full source voltage, which means that I do have ground there. So I guess I'll just follow this line and see if I can find any type of points. It goes right into here, which goes right into the harness. And that harness goes all the way to the, here it is right here. It goes all the way through. And once it goes through the firewall, it hits the fuse on the power side. The ground side goes straight to this controller. And there is no connection in between, so that's why I'm confused on that. The demon eyes do not work because I simply forgot that I haven't installed the ground to them. This gets constant ground. That's why they don't work. So I'm not worried about that. And the only other thing is the strips and halos, which are on the same circuit. So that's what I'll be figuring out in the meantime. Hopefully I could get it figured out and put on a light show at night. But everything else works. Engine bay lights work. These work. Pretty sure the demon eyes work. If I make a harness that just goes to a constant ground, I'm pretty sure they'll work. It's just these LEDs and strips. I found some spare wiring that I had saved from when I first got the shell, because I knew it'd be useful. And I'm gonna use this to tie the demon eyes and the low beams together. So this would be the ground connection. It would basically split off, connect
from this one to the nearest one and connect this one to the farthest one. And that'll go ahead and connect both of those demon eyes to constant ground. So that should be all that I need. I went ahead and I plugged that harness in that I just made. I soldered up the connections right there, that red solder right there. And you can see it plugged in to both, well, that one and the other ones out there, plugged straight to ground. And that was all I needed. Now, it's kind of hard to see, but the demon eyes in the low beams are now lighting up on both sides. They're in that default white. Everything else still works, which means that now I have 3 out of 4 circuits functioning. The only thing left is the strips and halos, which I have to figure out what's going on with them. Can't wait to try this shit at night.
This is how it looks at night. And I do say that even without the halos and strips, I feel like this looks quite all right. Once I can get the halos and strips figured out, this will look even better because I'll have the chasing patterns and stuff like that. But I may need a replacement regulator in order to make that work or something like that. I'm talking to the company now, trying to figure out what's going on. But this is pretty much what I got to work with. This lets me know that all the circuitry is fine with these 3 lights and just one more circuit to go. Then whenever I get an actual battery, I can test the basic headlight functions and turn signals and stuff like that. But yeah, this is pretty much how it is. Engine bay lights, got the low beams with the etched lenses, high beams, both are demonized right now. Everything's individually controlled, so I can set it to whatever, put on a little light show. So if I wanted to go to a car show and show off, this would be cool. And definitely digging the lighting setup on the engine bay, because with the engine in there, with this setup, it's gonna light up the whole thing. So working at night, it's gonna be a breeze. Definitely liking how this came out and how this looks on the actual car. I know this is a short video, just kind of stay posted. More stuff to come as I figure things out, as more parts come in the mail. And yeah, I guess that's it. Like, comment, subscribe, follow the build. This should look good.